must be able to change lives. We must be able to impact lives. You know, one thing that I always look at the students of 1976 and think about is, how brave can you be?
For us as government, we are very excited that the NYDA, under the leadership of Sifiso Mtsweni, has made sure that this house is named after one of the foremost revolutionaries to ever to come from youth activism in South Africa, especially June 16, 1976. Tsietsi Mashinini has inspired the whole generation of activists to continue the struggle for freedom. Were it not be for Tsietsi Mashinini and other of his friends and colleagues, the freedom that we attained in 1994 would not have been realized. But today, when we look back at the history of Tsietsi Mashinini, we want that kind of militance that characterized the June 16th detachment to be translated into the new era of the economic emancipation of our country. So we expect young people to be at the forefront of development, to be at the forefront of the economy, not just as job seekers, but as job creators. So the whole issue of the economic emancipation of our people is on the agenda.
You'd know that every year we celebrate Youth Month. But every year, you know, there's names like Hector Peterson, names like Nkgubutse Tiro, you know, but there's very little that is said about Tsietsi Mashinini. Now, if you follow the history of June 16, actually, he was the main architect, the brains behind it. And we feel that as a country, we need to celebrate him more and not forget him, because year in and year out, his name seems to fade away. So for us, when we took this office, we thought it was the best location for us to remind South Africans that our freedom did not come cheap. It came through the blood and the sweat of young people in this country, particularly students. So for us, it's a very touching moment to see his family here, you know, to really interact with them and interact with history. Because for us, Tsietsi Mashinini represents the real hero about June 16, 1976.
Definitely, we put more resources on youth development, because we know that 27.7% unemployment in our country, which is very huge, the majority of the people who bear the brunt of unemployment are young people. So we need to give hope to young people to realize that there's a future in South Africa. So that's why this whole issue of a radical socio-economic transformation is the agenda of our government and our ruling party, to make sure that young people must be the beneficiaries of this constitutional democracy that we have attained.
Year in and year out, we have students on the streets demanding one thing and one thing only: access to education, particularly the poor and the working class. Now, the NSFAS system to us is a law. It means that it also imposes a burden on its beneficiaries, because when they finish, as soon as they get a small annual job, even if it's an internship, they are told that they need to start paying back that particular money. So we say maybe that system needs to be changed, you know. For instance, you'd know that South Africa goes and says we can host the Rugby World Cup, there's money. When there's 2010 Soccer World Cup, there's money. When there's this all glitz and glam things, there's money. But when there's education, there's all these committees and commissions and what. We simply say, take NSFAS, it's a loan, turn it, make it a grant. We have achieved free education in this country.
Yes, definitely. It's on the agenda. As the president said yesterday in his address at the National Council of Provinces, in his last address in the NCOP, that he's evaluating the report of Judge Heha on this matter and will be making this announcement soon. But I must acknowledge that our government, as the ANC, has education as its foremost priority. That's why we call it an apex priority, because without education, there can be no future. And young people need that education, not only education, but skills development, so that we impart appropriate skills that are needed by the economy for young people to be job creators in their own right.
Thank you once more.